what, you know why they do this. You know why they go out and get the Mickey Rourkes and the celebrities, you know, year after year, whether it's for WrestleMania or whether it's for TNA. Well, TNA went and got A.J. Brzezinski of the Chicago White Sox, and, you know.
Which was smart.
You know why
which was smart. I like
you know
that one. I like it
that.
When they did that.
But you know why they do that, because they want the mention on TMZ, and they want the mention in the national media, and if they get that, they've accomplished their goal. So it's just, I mean, as far as people saying why would they get Danny Bonaducci, there's your reason, because they want the media. Any media is good media, you know what I'm saying, unless it's like a Benoit story or something like that. But any media, I mean, if a celebrity's coming to the company and the media picks that up, they've accomplished their goal. You know what I'm saying?
So what should I be looking forward to the next pay-per-view, like a Tonya Hardy? Nancy Kerrigan, maybe inside of a steel cage.
Well, we've got Destination X on Sunday, so that's our next TNA pay-per-view. So we're at least one pay-per-view away before we have to suffer through this guy wrestling on a TNA pay-per-view. He's actually going to be at Lockdown, which is going to be held up in Philadelphia. So that's the basic gist. But they're going to hype this guy up for the next couple weeks, and who knows, man, who knows? Maybe we will. Nancy Kerrigan, Tonya Harding, like you said, who knows, baby?
It reminds me of the Smoking Gun, because that's where he's, I remember Donnie, you know, watching him, because my TiVo records the Smoking Gun. It's like it's a TV show about funny skits, you know, reality funny skits, you know, people in surfs and they bump into a wall and stuff like that, and that's where I remember him from mostly, because again, I try to watch that every week because I need to laugh. If it works for TNA and if they need to bring in a D-list celebrity, go for it. You know, I mean, I honestly would rather see him than a Palin gimmick. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, at least here you have a real stream celebrity rather than, you know, imitating one. You know, so, hey, if it works for TNA, if it gets them on TV, and if it gets them on TMZ, and if that's what they're looking for, by all means, go for it.
So what you're saying is Danny Bonaducci equals ratings. No.
Is that right. What you thought I said?
No.
Let me explain that real quick. I can care less.
I'm sure everybody else could care less. I'm right there with you.
As long as it's I admire TNA because they're trying to, you know, they're trying to go out there and make a name for themselves, and I completely respect that, and I completely respect the fact that they don't sit there and lay down and let the WWE's numbers, you know, kind of like scare them, because a lot of people will. They won't take that extra step to get themselves out there, and that's exactly what their tagline calls it, cross the line.
Cross the line, baby. Cross the line, no doubt. Hey, let's get back to Monday Night Raw. We're just, like I said, we're going to highlight the big spots, the big happenings from Raw. And then I want to talk about the leaked Raw script, and I want to get into a little bit of a debate about you, about the big story, like I was saying earlier, news leaking online. I mean, they're not happy about this. They're not happy about spoilers getting out. So I want to talk about that with you, and we're going to talk about the Raw script that leaked online as well. Next big thing that happened on Raw, we had JBL. Speaking of the Raw script, we had JBL win the Intercontinental title last week. And interesting note here, if you guys read the Raw script from last week's show, they had a basically what was scheduled to happen was JBL was to come out, cut an in-ring promo, CM Punk would come out, cut him off, and then they'd do a non-title match. Last week, it would be a non-title match. They never wound up doing that due to time constraints last week. So that was dropped, and then the script leaked online, and that was all in the script for last week's show. And then this week, they came out, didn't do a non-title match, just did a regular title match, and then did the switch. I know why they did that, because you've only got a couple weeks, so you had to get the title change done now, leading into WrestleMania, and then you have a storyline where JBL goes and defends the IC title at WrestleMania. That's his historic WrestleMania. He's been writing blogs on the WWE Universe site. I guess is it true the Intercontinental title has never been defended on a WrestleMania?
Did you forget Ricky Steamboat versus Randy Savage WrestleMania 3?
I guess I did. Well, what is he talking about historic? What is he doing?
He's an idiot. I don't know. Maybe he's doing a match. You know, the most person eats the hot dogs wins the Intercontinental title. I mean, it's another gimmick that JBL is coming up with.
Robo Fight Night. This is no Ryan. It has never been retained. It's never been retained at WrestleMania. So that's okay. Whatever. It's never been retained. What do you mean by never been retained?
I guess someone defends it and lost it. So no one has actually won the title back or retained the title back. I think that's what.
He says he's going to go to WrestleMania with the IC title and retain it, walk out of WrestleMania as IC champion.
Right, which has never been done before.
That's his big. I thought it was something bigger than that, man. I mean, Jesus. If you're talking historic, man.
Someone hit the alarm clock and wake me up when his promo is done.
Yeah, right. Ryan, are you? Wow. I guess if that's your example of historic, or that's how you're gonna go about it, I guess. Whatever. But anyways, he's gonna defend the. Who do you think he's gonna defend the title against? Because CM Punk is in the Money in the Bank match, so he'd defend against who? JBL would start a storyline. How about Rey Mysterio? Somebody asked me about Rey Mysterio earlier, and I said I have no idea what they're going to do with Rey. I figured that maybe they'd throw him in the WWE.com match. I still believe that they're going to have a WWE.com match prior to WrestleMania going live. So, yeah, they could do, I mean, Rey Mysterio, right? Rey Mysterio. And then if Rey Mysterio won the IC title, right, that would give him a brand-new storyline coming out of WrestleMania. And Rey with the IC title makes sense, you know?
I mean, it's so far, if you look at the Raw roster, mainstream names, the only really person that's not on that it is exactly who you just said. It's Rey Mysterio, because now you have Kofi in the ladders match. You have the other guys. I mean, granted, we're still forgetting Ted DiBiase and Cody Rhodes. They're so far not part of WrestleMania, unless I missed something somewhere.
They're not.
You know, Batista's out. John Cena's already in a triple threat match.
Somebody in the chat room said Santino, but I mean, this is a guy that. I don't know what he did to piss off somebody. You know what I mean? This is a guy that was on Raw week after week after week, and I think he worked a dark match 2 weeks ago prior to the show. Hasn't been on Raw since. You know,
It's almost like they're being cautious with him. You don't want to see him every single week because then he becomes stale. Perfect example: Ron Simmons with the Damn. You know,
true,
every
true.
Week it was funny until like the seventh time. You're like, and you're telling yourself, Damn. Like, he comes back up, damn, okay, we already know what you're going to say. And I think that's probably the reason why they're kind of preserving him. But they're smart because they still put him out there when Beth comes out. So you're still seeing him, but I just don't see a JBL versus Santino, Matt. It just, the way as Santino's been losing recently, it just doesn't make sense. I like to see a JBL versus Rey. Then that's a different scenario. Now we're talking a little bit something different, you know.
Yeah, and Rey makes sense, man. Rey makes sense with the IC title. That's a guy that if he had the IC belt around his waist, I mean, that's a guy that you would say, all right, Rey is IC champion. I like it, you know? And it gets Rey on
WrestleMania. I just don't agree with the JBL. I mean, winning an Intercontinental title, I mean, that's just.
Yeah, but it could be that he has the IC title and then he goes to WrestleMania and then he loses it there to Rey Mysterio, a guy that goes in there and says, I promise you I will make history at WrestleMania. I'm definitely going to make history 100%. I'm walking out of WrestleMania, IC champion, this and that. And, of course, it doesn't happen at the end and Rey walks out. Rey gets the win. JBL gets pissed off. You continue the storyline, but you've got Rey as IC champion coming out of WrestleMania. I like it, man. I like it.
I like it, too. I mean, don't get me wrong. I mean, it would be something awesome to see.
As long as Rey walks out with the title.
I don't think he will. I don't think they'll put the title on JBL and then lose it in less than a month. I mean, JBL has a lot of pull in that company. and him
That's
to
true.
lose a title that just it just destroys his credibility. If he's coming out and saying record blah, this is gonna happen and never happened before at WrestleMania history and this and that, and then he loses, his credibility is kind of shot. And he has to be careful because of that. I mean, not only that, because of wrestling-related, storylines, but on a personal level, as well as shooting his mouth so largely.